Everyday stress can drive some people to consume alcohol and tobacco just to cope. But what happens when the stress reliever becomes an addiction?
WDSU reporter Gina Swanson talks to one woman about her struggle with alcohol and examines a local study that shows why African-American women in some neighborhoods may be more susceptible to high-risk drinking.
I started at the age of 13 years old. I was feeling overwhelmed, very stressed.
That was the first time Sharice Griffin had a drink, and she's had a battle with a bottle ever since.
I just became a different person that I liked when I first started drinking alcohol. I liked it. I liked the feeling it gave me. It helped me to be less stressful.
Sharice is not alone. Research suggests that stress is a major factor that drives people to alcohol and tobacco.
It's a form of self-medicating, numbing oneself of the reality that they're living in. Now, I do hear a lot of people say, I smoke because of bad nerves, and it settles me down.
For Griffin, her stress was the result of being a people pleaser, feeling that she didn't measure up.
I just felt uncomfortable in my own skin.
Stress aside, a study published last year by Tulane University suggests that where you live can also influence how much you drink. The research sampled more than 300 African Americans who use community clinics here in the city. The findings: among drinkers, those who live in neighborhoods with a high density of liquor stores are more likely to be at-risk drinkers, and that phenomena is even more likely for Black women. Consider this. On one street in this Central City neighborhood that's predominantly African American, we counted 6 alcohol beverage outlets in less than a mile. While some neighborhoods seem to have liquor stores on just about every block of the street, for Sharice Griffin, she's on the road to recovery. And her journey started with this revelation.
I'm totally powerless over alcohol, and I've come to that conclusion completely. Because I had to live to drink and drink to live.
Through this program at Grace House and encouragement from family and friends, Sharice is following the steps to a new life.
And we don't need alcohol or any drugs as a crutch.
A message she wants to get out to others who may be struggling with addiction.
I believe they're going to be proud of me because I need to get the message out that we don't have to drink to make ourselves feel better or to love ourselves. We have to love have to come from within us.
A sobering realization for Sharice, who continues to embrace her new life one day at a time. On your side, Gina Swanson, WDSU News.
The people at the Grace House allowed our cameras in to shoot this story. And if you know someone struggling with addiction or seeking treatment yourself, they offer several programs that can help. Contact Grace House at 504-821-7120.